What is so interesting here is that I have a traditional food blog, and I blog a lot about nutrient dense recipes and healing remedies. And you came from a nutritionalist background too. You actually went to school and had all that certification and years of training. So I just kind of want to tie it back into for my audience who watch a lot of my cooking videos, how is the emotion code we're going to talk about today tie into this whole holistic healing stuff? And so maybe we can start with you telling a little bit of your story and how you get here, and how is this helping our audience in this broader way of healing, helping them?
Yes. Thank you. Wow. That is a big question, a very important question, and I love it. So thanks for the intro. So just to introduce myself to your viewers, my name is Kristy Marie Campbell. I am, as you mentioned, I'm a registered holistic nutritionist, and more recently, I'm a certified emotion code practitioner. And like Yang, I'm sure many of Yang's viewers have read her story around her healing, and it's quite the story. And I've been on a similar healing journey myself. I'll put it that way. It's likely just from a more kind of body perspective or physiological perspective. I've been the last several years, I've been working on gut issues. I've likely been exposed to Lyme and had some mold illness. And so I was in a software career for a very long time, and ended up coming out and going back to school for nutrition as part of my own journey. But so earlier on in my journey, I was using a lot of, again, the protocols like Yang mentioned. I mean, we're both very much all about real food healing, being a foundation to health and wellness. So I did a lot of bone broths. I did a lot of just really natural foods, soups and things like that. And I really started noticing a difference in my physical body, though along the way. And, you know, I'm sure same thing as many people over the last several years, but with COVID and everything in the world the last few years, we just decided to change a whole bunch of other things up, and we moved, our kids changed schools and all kinds of things. And a lot of emotions were present. A lot of emotional content was coming up that I was really feeling in my body. And I can't remember how I actually came along to the emotion code. I feel like it literally fell out of a shelf at a bookstore when I was there with a couple of friends, but it really resonated, because what I learned is that, of course, our physical vessel with the foods we eat, what we drink, supplements and things like that, they're all super important in order to be healthy, but there's a lot more to the puzzle. And Yang talks about holistic healing, and I really believe that as well, that there's a whole body, mind, spirit part of it all. And a lot of us, especially early in our journeys, we really focus on the eating, the supplements, the exercise, the sleep, all really important things. But the whole field of the emotional side of things, super important. So how the emotion code fits in is, well, first of all, here's the book. So there's a book on it. There's also a certification program, which I went through. And the author of the book and the originator of the system, his name is Dr. Bradley Nelson. He's a holistic physician. And he discovered the system back in, I believe it was 2007. But what he was finding with his patients is, again, there's a lot of missing pieces to the healing. There's a huge emotional component. And a lot of our times in our lives, we go through experiences that are quite hard emotionally. So it could be something that could be grief, it could be anxiety, it could be a lot of stress, it could be a heartbreak, it could be missing someone, feeling longing, but it almost feels too hard in our bodies at times to actually feel those emotions. We're used to being in our heads, right? We're very analytical people. We've come to, we're all very thinky, perhaps too. So when we start to feel things, sometimes it could be overwhelming. And what our bodies will do is it will quite literally trap emotions in our bodies and say, like, no, I can't handle that. I'm going to deal with that later, which might be a good mechanism in the moment in order to kind of get through whatever the thing is in life. But then later on, these emotions, they stay, they don't go anywhere and they build up. So we can be having hundreds, if not even more, emotions build up in our bodies. And what can happen is that can get in the way of health and wellness. That could be a contributing factor to certain states of disease or discomfort in the body. It could contribute towards strange behavioral patterns or habits that we can't break. And we're like, why can't I break this thing? I want to break it. You know, I want to heal this thing. I'm doing all the right things, but it could be that trapped emotions are an underlying factor. So that was a lot. Maybe I'll just pause there, Yang, and see if you wanted to take that any particular way, if there's anything that I left out you'd like your viewers to know.
No, I just think this is really amazing. And what's so interesting is, like, you and I, we had almost identical journey, right? Like you said, we both came from this IT background and we were like software developers, you know, the two girls. And then we did this whole nutrition thing, trying to heal ourselves and, you know, eating all the right food supplements. And then, but over the years, like simultaneously, you and I think we both grew more spiritually and then able to tune into our emotions more and understanding that we need to, like, I think in the emotion code that Dr. Bradley Nelson talk about, right? Like opening up the heart wall. Mm-hmm. And like I think both of us recognize that, how we need to open up ourselves so that, you know, mm-hmm. our emotion can flow and we can, like, you know, vibrate at a higher level. All mm-hmm. of that. It's energetic healing, right?
Yes. Yes, absolutely. Thank you for saying that word there, because absolutely. Yeah. Uh-huh. The emotion code it's one of many different beautiful tools that have been, I'm not sure even what word is, invented. You know, some people might say downloaded, because literally in some cases, someone will have almost like a divine, mm-hmm. inspiration of some of a healing modality. That's the way some have mm-hmm. come to be, right? And really, in the end, humans are both in form. We have a form, mm-hmm. but everything is also energy if you look at the quantum mm-hmm. physics side of things. So what's really beautiful is, again, there are so many systems out there that could help, mm-hmm. and that science is actually really coming a long way to show that energy healing really does make a difference. I mean, you can't see it so tangibly. Mm-hmm. There's experiments where, just at a super high level, for example, one experiment where they had a number of people at a distance send loving energy from their hearts to one particular plant out of a number of plants in a room somewhere else in the world. And they did that from some period of time, and the plant that they were sending the love to thrived more than the other plants. And this wasn't a one-off. There are literally hundreds of studies showing how intention and positive energy can heal. Mm. So it's a beautiful field. It's an exciting time where more and more of this field, it's being brought into more of the mainstream, and I'm excited to see where that goes. I'm really excited to see more I suppose you can say an integration of mm-hmm. more of the mainstream side of things and more, I guess, esoteric energy type healing, mm-hmm. because I think then we'd have a really powerful system to help people be their best selves.
Yes, that's so beautiful. And I think both of us, we have seen a lot of people in our own healing experience, like other people struggling with health issues. And a lot of them came from childhood trauma. And then that becomes the blockage and becomes a reason for people experience unexplainable chronic pains for years. Yeah. And oftentimes because they have like anger and pain and struggles that they couldn't resolve within themselves. So so this is something like I wish I knew earlier. And I think both of us would have benefited so much, right, in our earlier years of struggles. But at the same time, I'm actually thinking, like, maybe I wouldn't be so receptive to it many years earlier, because, you know, we also have to come through our own journey in order to get to this place of acceptance and understanding the importance of it. Yeah. So I'm very excited for what you're doing. And so I actually have the honor to experience a few sessions with you. Mm-hmm. And it was so beautiful and so therapeutic. I absolutely love all of the experience.
And, yeah, that was really nice. We had a couple of really nice sessions together.
Yeah.
I had quite a nice one with your husband as well. And yeah, if I could just add in here, I mean, he, even though he's, I don't think you've talked too much on your blog, but he's not as much in more of the holistic space. It was really gratifying to hear afterwards where we just did a session to kind of lighten things up for him. And he sent me a nice note afterwards saying, you know, he wasn't sure how he felt more logically about it, but it definitely something shifted. So another interesting thing about this work is that even if someone's feeling a little bit skeptical, it just works because energy doesn't lie. So just thought I'd throw that in there too.
Yes, absolutely. And then you also talk about this not only work for humans, it also work on pets. So that's really fascinating. And, you know, like all of us are affected and the kind of emotion we feel in our body. So maybe you can give a few examples of what kind of symptoms and issues people can use emotion code to, you know, resolve.
Yeah, for sure. And I think, again, the beautiful thing is there's really the sky's the limit, right? I mean, it works so well with other modalities people might be doing. It really, you can use it as a general tool just to kind of clear whatever is, you know, ready to release to feel lighter, or you can use it much more specifically. So a few examples of setting a specific intention, which made a difference pretty quickly for people. One person mentioned some lower back pain. And so I asked him to rate it on a scale from 1 to 10. And he said it was about a 5 at the time. He'd kind of wake up in the morning and feel kind of rough each day and then just kind of power through. So we did one session for him and I asked him how it felt immediately afterwards. And he said, just like that, it had dropped from a 5 to a 3. And then I heard a note from him the next morning saying, wow, I actually woke up and don't feel the usual discomfort. So that was a pretty big shift. I'll give a couple examples of physical improvements as well as more mental, emotional, or behavioral type improvements as well. Another one in more of the physical domain was someone had been having some pretty significant pain and tightness along her thigh, kind of going around to the lower back again. And she's an avid hiker. She's very active. She likes to do climbing as well. And that was getting in the way of her walking. She wasn't able to walk or hike as far. So after one session, she was feeling pretty incredibly that it was gone. Like the tightness and the pain was actually fully gone. And she said over the coming days, some of it came back in. And that's sometimes what we experience because healing happens in, it's like an onion, it happens in layers. But she said it was a substantial improvement and it never got back to the level of tightness or pain that she had been in. Another really cool one was that someone had been experiencing an inner ear condition. The name of the condition eludes me, but essentially she'd been having dizziness spells throughout the day. And pretty much every day she'd have multiple episodes. And after we did a session, I heard she kept messaging me that evening saying, I can't believe this, but it's gone. I haven't had a single episode. It's gone. It's gone. So each time I hear that, it just floors me. I'm just so grateful to have discovered this work because, I mean, I feel like I'm literally here to heal myself and then to help heal others in different ways. So these stories are amazing. So those were a few physical type improvements as well. Yang had mentioned that emotion code can really do a service for people in the heart area, like really kind of help them open their heart. And in fact, a little bit of an aside, one of the specific things that can be done with emotion code is clearing something called a heart wall. What Dr. Brad discovered is people can literally almost wall up emotions around their heart if feeling like if they've had so much heartbreak or if they feel like it's not safe to love, people can literally wall themselves up around their heart around their heart. And so we can set the intention to remove that heart wall. And when I did that for one person in particular, she reached out a few days later and said that there was this particular grudge that had been with her for a long time, or this really kind of harder feeling. I can't remember if it was around a specific person or just kind of something in general that came up for her, but she said she just felt lightness there. She didn't feel that grudge anymore. So that was, again, really nice to hear.
That is really amazing, right?
And I've heard different feelings from other people around just this kind of feeling of lightness, like they're just getting more in touch with their body and they're just feeling more loving overall.
While you're telling all of the stories, how much, like, in the society we talk about mental health and advocating for it, but there's like very little tools and modalities like out there to help people. You know, we can just be advocating forever, but this is actually a tool that can like make some permanent shift in people's mental well-being. The mental well-being piece tie into all the physical stuff, and this is good for the mental, good for the physical. And when you talk about heart wall opening up, it's great for relationships, you know, love, and you know, all of that, for everyone around us. So in Eastern medicine, and the different emotions are tied to like different organs in our body. Mm-hmm. So I think there's a lot of that kind of maybe correlations and like in your practice, right, that you see and you actually make use of when you're healing your clients.
And yeah,
well, it's absolutely interesting, believe in all of that.
It's interesting you mentioned the organs. Absolutely. I mean, it's even going back to my nutrition program, there was a body, mind, spirit course, which talked about how often certain organs are related to certain emotions, like the liver, for example, can hold anger, the kidneys can hold fear. So if we're we're sort of clogged, if you will, in different ways and we're not flowing, then those can be emotions that would sort of plague us more. Mm-hmm. And not to say they're bad per se. I mean, humans are designed to feel both the more positive, lighter emotions, as well as feel the harder ones. But the key is that we need to feel them, accept them, not judge them, and like sort of let them flow through. And it's when our bodies clench and hold on to them, that's when more of these longer term symptoms and patterns and things can develop.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah. This is bringing, you know, the emotion code together with all our body healing. I don't want to, you know, turn my blog into a podcast. This is not the intention of the direction we're going, but I really want to emphasize on this piece because I want to be able to talk about holistic healing in the way that we need to look into every part of our body, right? Not just the food, not just the eating. And then there's also, I talk about detox, I talk about emotional well-being, all that, like, you know, spiritual connections, and it's overall healing. So that's why this kind of connections is so important, like the emotions actually attached to our bodies.
Yeah. Just a note on what you just said there. You mentioned spiritual, just at a very high level around that. Another really beautiful benefit of a tool like emotion code is as we're clearing out what no longer serves us, we're making space for, and I'm getting shivers saying this because it's really true. We're making space for our greatest happiness as well as our greatest purpose and contribution. So we get rid of sort of all that heavier density than what we get more coming to us around what's ours to do, what's our greatest joy to experience, what's our greatest way of serving others, basically what's ours, each of ours individually to do in our lives. So
I love that. And okay, so one of the sessions you did for me, so what's really interesting is you discover some kind of trapped emotion that's not from my own experience, but that's from inherited trapped emotion of my ancestor. Am I saying it correctly?
Yes,
so absolutely. It could be like going back many generations. So I actually did a little bit of research after that. And then, so what I'm hearing is when my trapped emotion is cleared, it's also cleared up multiple generations through the spirit. Is that a correct interpretation?
I'm glad you brought that part up. So absolutely, emotion code includes a component where there can be some inherited or ancestral healing in it. So just to kind of back up for a sec to make this a little more clear. So in a session, and Yang and I are going to do a session today, I believe. Am I right?
Yeah, we're going to do one. So that, you know, just so that people can have a a taste of what
Yeah.
it looked like, right?
Perfect. Perfect. So I'll give a little bit of a preamble right now just to kind of go a little further with what Yang just said.
Yes, and I'm actually gonna separate that into a separate video. So, I'm gonna put a
Perfect.
link somewhere around there. And then, so if you're watching this video, you can find the link and then, go to the other one.
Okay, so I'll be really quick with it right now. But basically, when doing an emotion code session, most of the emotions that come out are called kind of common trapped emotions, which means that they originated somewhere within your life in this lifetime. So perhaps you were 12 years old and you went through an experience and it was really hard and you trapped an emotion at 12 years old, or you were 35, right? Sometime during your life, you trapped an emotion directly. That's called a common trapped emotion in the system. There's a few other types, with one of the probably the second most common one being, and I asked the question at the beginning as well to see what type of trapped emotion are we working with here that wants to come out. The second most common in my experience is an inherited trapped emotion. And what that is it's somewhere up the chain. So somewhere within your ancestors, someone experienced a trapped emotion. They carried it with them. They weren't able to resolve it. And essentially it got passed on generation to generation to, in this case, you, Yang. So you mentioned in your session one came out. So, or maybe a few of them came out. So it would have been somewhere up, either your mother or your father's lineage, somewhere up the chain, and then passed down to you. And like you mentioned, the really cool thing about finding and clearing an inherited trapped emotion is that it's cleared not only from your own body, but it's cleared from your ancestors that trapped it. And it's also cleared for any descendants that you might've passed it on to as well. And just one more thing on that. So clearing inherited trapped emotions is one exception to the general rule. There's a general rule of healing is that you don't do an energy healing on someone without their permission. But this is a case where, because you are clearing it yourself, it just sort of by proxy clears from your ancestors and any descendants. Mm-hmm. And you get that, little bit of extra freedom throughout the chain then. So, yeah.
Okay, so that is very good that you brought it up, because it's easier for people, I think, to understand the concept. Let's say if I'm a very young woman before conception of my baby, right? So obviously if I have trapped emotion that's being cleared is not going to be passed on to my future babies, right?
Right.
But
right.
You're saying that even if my children have already been born and
yeah.
I have already passed on maybe some old grudges or something to them, mm-hmm. and then at this point, when I heal myself emotionally, I heal them.
If it's an inherited trapped emotion, now from my understanding of the system, if you're clearing a common trapped emotion, it's only clearing from you.
Yes.
But if you're clearing an inherited one, that's when you get more of the breadth of the the healing. And having said that as well, just an aside, I mean, children are they're much more in general in touch with their bodies, in touch with their hearts. So emotion code works very well on children. That's also a case where, just as an aside too, where someone that's under 18, a parent can give the approval to have a session done on their child. Like they can give, what's the word I'm looking for? Well, I'll just use approval for the session on the child. But yes, children are very open to this type of work, and often results are seen really quickly, as well as animals, like we mentioned earlier.
Yes. So I have done allergy clearance for my children, so which is a very similar thing to what emotional you're doing, but not in the emotional realm, right? It's using some of the same similar techniques and muscle testing and stuff, but clearing their allergies, just by listening to their body wisdom. So in ways there are a lot of similarity to it. And my children, when it comes to little kids, the success it just come really quickly, right? So
yeah, I love that. I love that you've seen that with them. And yeah, in the end, whether it's an emotion, whether it's a food, quite literally everything has a particular vibration. Mm-hmm. And so whether it's a food, our bodies decided like, oh, that's unsafe, even though it should be fine. It's a food, right? And it could be, So whether it's a food, whether it's emotion, it's basically our body has decided, oh, for whatever reason, it's not safe to have that thing in me. So it'll kind of squirrel it away. It'll react to it. Mm-hmm. But if we just sort of give it love and give it permission to release, slightly different for, you know, clearing food sensitivities versus emotions, but just give it that opportunity to release. And then the body has a chance to recalibrate and say, okay, I feel safe. I'm no longer going to have issue with this particular thing.
Right. I'm just trusting the body, right? Trusting the body telling us what is there to stay and what need to be let go of.
Yeah. And the bodies are super intelligent, and that's what it comes down to. And I mean, we are very, very lucky to have, you know, just to kind of put this in place as well, a medical system where, you know, our bodies get to a point, you know, we have an acute injury or a heart attack or something really goes acutely wrong in our bodies. I'm so happy to have the system we have with surgery, you know, very dedicated surgeons and doctors and whatnot. And that's why, again, I'm happy to see coming together where there's more acceptance for energy medicine, because a lot of these things can be handled earlier on before they turn into disease, right? At more of that energetic level, just to kind of allow our bodies to balance themselves the best they can. And because tissues want to regenerate, right? And if we give the body everything it needs, food, love, trust, and clearing out of what no longer serves, then our bodies can be very intelligent and they can heal themselves in a lot of cases.
Absolutely. So it all fit into the same philosophy we always have, that our body have this immense power to heal. All we need to do is give it the balance and give it the right condition and believe in that power.
Beautiful. 100%.
Okay. That's so great. Maybe we'll get into a little more technical stuff of emotion code. And I know a little earlier I talked about muscle testing that I have experienced with other healing method, and I know that with emotion code you also use muscle testing. Maybe explain that a little bit. Maybe a lot of people don't know what muscle testing is.
Yes, absolutely. So we're going to get a little bit detailed about the system itself and how it works, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, perfect. Yes, so the emotion code is fundamentally based on muscle testing. So there's many, many different methods of muscle testing. I'll put it that way. So for those not in the know, muscle testing is a way to get answers in a space that you can't so much see, touch, and feel, right? So we're really tapping into, again, energetics. In the case of emotion code, we're tapping into a person or an animal's subconscious mind, right? You can kind of think of things like an iceberg, right? So our conscious mind is like, I think a certain thing. I feel hungry. I'm going to go make a sandwich. I'm going to go do this now. And it's thinking. It's being very consciously aware of things. That's kind of the tip of the iceberg that's above the water, right? We all know that iceberg analogy. But once you go underneath, then you get into a much bigger area of the subconscious. So it's things that, it's intuition. It's a field of intuition. It's the field of, you know, something kind of I'm feeling. I don't quite know what it is. Like, it's the stuff that's not as tangible, right? So what we do with emotion code is we're using muscle testing. There's many methods. I use one called a finger and ring method. But we use that to get answers for the subconscious mind. So you can do you can learn muscle testing by starting with a baseline. It could be yes, no, right? Where a strong is yes and a weak is no. And so you can see with my hand here, I'm going to say yes. And you can see I can't open up my other hand there, right? This is open, but I'm saying yes. I literally, quite literally cannot open that ring. And then I say no, and it wants to break apart. Or similarly, I can say happy, joy, love, or I can say anger, terror, you know, fighting. So it's showing a strong versus a weak. So then the way emotion code works, that incorporates in by after we set the intention of the session. It could be either a general intention, or it can be something more specific, like say someone wants to work on lower back pain. We say, okay, we're going to set the intention. I get the permission from the other person to start the emotion code session, and then I dive right in. And so I'll be asking questions throughout using muscle testing. And the whole system is actually very, very simple at its core. And I'll show you my phone, because what Dr. Bradley has realized is that even though there's hundreds of very, very specific vibrations of emotions. The main ones in terms of clearing can be encapsulated with this chart of 60 emotions, 60 kind of heavier, denser, like harder to process type emotions. And so the emotion code process is first asking us if there's an emotion we can clear. I get the yes. And then I ask, is it a common emotion? Like I mentioned earlier, does that originate in that person's or animal's life? And if I either get a yes and I continue on, or I figure out the other type of emotion it might be. And then from there, I go through this chart and I simply say, is the emotion we're clearing in column A, column B? And then from there, I go odd row, even row, and then I get a cell of five emotions and I go through each emotion to get the specific one that wants to be released. So it's my left brain prior software career version of myself actually kind of loves it because it's a really nice, simple system. They just follow through. And people get it too. Like people get emotions, right? And it's very tangible for people. So I get down to emotion that wants to be cleared. And then I ask, is there anything else I need to know about this emotion? And again, I muscle test. And if the answer is no, I can go ahead and clear it on the person's behalf. So because energy does not know time or space, I can either be physically with the person, in which case I can clear the emotion on their body, or I can make this proxy connection like I'm doing with Yang today and clear the emotion on her behalf using my own body. Mm-hmm. And the way it's cleared is super simple. It uses magnets, mm-hmm. and we literally do a swipe over my head in this case, since we're connected remotely, and just hold the intention to release that energy. And then I check at the end, did this emotion clear, and get a yes or a no. And that is that. That's literally that. And then we repeat that process until the person's subconscious says, I'm basically done. This is enough emotional movement for today. And then we're done. So it's really neat. And you'll see more as we get into the session. But one thing I just want to add here as well is there are many, many energetic or emotional type clearing or healing modalities out there. Two things I really like about emotion code is one, it's so simple. Again, people can really understand it. I'm gonna say three things. There's a lot of things I love. Two, people often have shifts right away, which is just so beautiful to hear. And then they can see something actually really work for me. And the third thing is that I like to think of it, it's a really gentle clearing. There's some techniques out there that are a lot more, shall we say, intense, right? People really go in, they do inner child work, they really dive deep down. I mean, there's plant medicines that people can use to really do this healing work. They can be quite intense. It can be very effective, but they can be quite intense on the body. And emotion code, it's generally very gentle. Sometimes people will feel kind of like a signature of the emotion coming back out. Sometimes there might be some tears. Sometimes it might just be lightness. They might get a really good night's sleep. Usually it is a very gentle clearing, a very gentle peeling of the outer layers of the onion, which is great as well, because I like to see that as opposed to, you know, people have day-to-day lives, they have kids, they have jobs, and they want to continue on with that. So it's not always an option to need to take, you know, 3, 4, 5 days to recover from something really intense. So again, maybe I'll pause there, see if there's any other questions, if I missed anything, and we can go from there.
Yeah, so I think when it comes to releasing trapped emotions, it's kind of like a detox. Yeah. And then, right, when we do physical detox, there's going to be side effects. And so when people do emotional detox, what are the kind of side effects that, you know, people will experience?
Yeah, well, that's, you have great questions, first of all. I love it.
Because so I experienced this, right? Because we did this many times.
Yes. Well, I mean, like I mentioned, I suppose sort of a re-experiencing a little bit of that emotion, like say you cleared some heartbreak, like maybe you have a little bit of tears come out. That's almost like a detox, right? Your body is literally, the tears are allowing some release from your body. You could find, the person can find that there are more physical, like you might get more of a physical reaction. So, what are some examples? This is a bit of a funny one, but this is how I tend to detox myself. Someone might end up like going to the bathroom a little bit more often, right? Like it's, again, physically a detox that you're eliminating. Mm. There might be changes in your skin, right? Like just, you might have a little bit of a breakout and then a clearing. Like it could literally come through in different physical ways. Mm-hmm. There could be more yawning. There could be, you know, someone might I'm just trying to think what other things people have reported. You might literally feel movement. You might find that you're feeling things in your body more, like feeling movement through your body. There could be sweating, right? Like there's a lot of ways our bodies have to release things. So it could feel more physical or it could feel more emotional, but in the end, it's all good. And I always say drink lots of water because water helps us clear things out, and just get as much rest and take care of yourself after a session the best that you can, and just really give yourself grace and allow the process to unfold.
Right. That's great. So just basically feel through it and allow whatever that need to come out, whatever need to happen and that's just all part of the process.
Right. Like no judgment, right? I mean, I think this is a big part of it too, right? It's just learning to say that something is right, just the way it is, right? No judgment, nothing's wrong. You know, our bodies are designed to do this whole thing. So just if something is happening following a session that might feel less pleasant, you know, just remember, again, our bodies are designed to feel things and it's completely right. And it's only going to be going in the direction of more happiness, lightness, and joy in someone's life.
Earlier, we talked a little bit about doing emotional call session in person versus remote. And do you want to share a little bit about how people can book you if they want to have a remote session with you or in person?
Yeah, perfect. Thank you. So as of right now, my online presence, I'm keeping it simple with the social media thing right now. So my business is currently the presence is a Facebook page. So if you were to go onto facebook.com/Kristy Marie Wellness, and Yang, I assume you could put that link right below. Mm-hmm. So very simple. I post information about emotion code. There is a link to book directly in my calendar. Or if you have questions, want to know if this could be right for you, that sort of thing, want to kind of see if this could be a fit, then you can send me a direct message on Facebook as well. I'm just kind of going with the flow here in terms of, because I do want to develop a website and whatnot and kind of have more assets at a later point, as well as possibly offer, you know, nutritional counseling. There's a lot of ideas, but right now doing emotion code is really feeling like it's the way I can make the most of an impact for people. Mm-hmm. So it's on Facebook. Thanks so much for allowing me to share that, Yang.
So you also have Instagram. That's correct.
I do. I have a personal Instagram. Oh, I haven't created one specifically for my business yet, but my personal Instagram's fun. I post a lot of food photos. I do post some things of our family, my kids, nature, gardening. So, you know, if that's your thing as well, then if you want to put my more personal Instagram on there too, then happy to connect that way as well. I do occasionally put some of my emotion code information into my personal Instagram too. So feel free to connect with me either way.
Yeah, so absolutely. I'm going to have all of your contact information down there. And then again, like, I think you have this whole spectrum experience and from nutrition, and you're so logical and you're so spiritual and you're so, like, you know, intuitive, all of that, and you bring such good you know, healing and information for your client.
Thank you. Yeah, I mean,
I love to share,
you know, I love to connect with people. It just brings me, like, honestly, it just brings me so much happiness to share things that could help people out, that could inspire people, and that can help people heal. So
yeah, and you really have that knowledge and the capacity, right?
Thank you so much. Mm-hmm. Thank you. And yeah, just an aside as well, you had mentioned booking online sessions. So that is the way that I work mainly, as I do remote work. So I do a lot of Zoom calls. Mm-hmm. It's always nice, I find, to actually see the person I'm doing a session with and meet that way. However, perfectly, the process also works very well over the phone. So for people that like the phone would rather not be on video, that's completely fine. Mm-hmm. And for people that would really rather not be in either, they just want to kind of be in their own space during the process, that's again the neat thing about energy work, is that it doesn't require this kind of direct one-on-one conversation to work. So a friend of mine named this for me because I was trying to come up with a name, but I said, what's a name for a session when they're just in their own space? I'm over here doing it. Is it an email session? Like, what is it? And then she said, it's an NPR session, which is kind of funny because I know that's a program, but no presence required. Mm. So your presence is not required. It is nice to be able to maybe chat through email or have a picture of the human or the animal that I'm working with to help me sort of connect mm-hmm. in. But if you don't want to be on the phone or video, then mm-hmm. I can certainly work with that too.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. So all of the sessions that you and I have done together in the past are all through video. And mm-hmm. so I have some personal experience with the remote session. And when I can see you, and of course, you and I, we have really good connection. So yeah. we're always like intuitively connected yeah. and having great results. So I think that kind of lead into the next question a little bit. Like, what do you want, let's say someone come to you to do to prepare for a session in order for the best result?
Yeah, well, so, I mean, the first thing I would say is, as with anything in life, really just kind of listen to yourself. And if it feels like something that's for you, you feel like drawn toward it, mm-hmm. then I welcome you to take that leap and connect with me, make a mm-hmm. session, or if you have any questions, I'm happy to answer them. If you're thinking like, oh, this isn't for me, you know, first of all, honor that. So mm-hmm. yeah. that's the first thing you want to say. But then if you do feel like you want to move ahead, it would be kind of more, what are you feeling? What's speaking to you loudly at this point? Is there a particular symptom, mm-hmm. set of symptoms that you feel like you want to work on? Is it more something emotional or behavioral or habit? Mm-hmm. I always ask, what's speaking loudest to you at this point? Because again, emotion code can work with anything that someone could be going through, anything that's challenging for them. Mm-hmm. You can have a single intention in a session. You can throw a few different intentions into the pot. And then really the subconscious is really intelligent and would serve up the best emotions to clear. Mm-hmm. In terms of prepping for the session itself, I would simply say give yourself a little bit of time and space if you can. If you can even grab just a half hour, again, it could be face to face, or if you want to just relax on your own time, grab a tea, you know, rest on the couch. It can even be done during your sleep. Really, the long short of it is there isn't really a lot to prepare, mm-hmm. other than feeling in, is this right for you? And then mm-hmm. setting that intention that you're here to make some shifts and mm-hmm. you're open to the work. And then, like we already talked about, the self-care recommended following the session is drinking lots of water and just honoring your body, because you might be doing some a little bit of gentle detoxing afterwards.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I want to second that on the setting intention. Mm-hmm. When we have done the sessions and I really focus on intentions, and we even make a little bit of a little list of things that we kind of want to like reach, right? Mm-hmm. It's like an internal goal that you have, and you want to be like tuning into that goal, that vision. So it's for me, it's like visualizing an end result, and then mm-hmm. wholeheartedly believing in that process. So mm-hmm. I think what's really important for like the recipient side, right, need to be open the heart, right? Like, you may be skeptical about it, and you may be like all in your logical mind, and then you're like, does it make any sense? Like, can I prove it scientifically? Like, if that's where you focus your energy on, like, it's not going to be as successful, as effective as you could have that experience to mm-hmm. be. So mm-hmm. Like, just open your heart and then set that intention and then just believe in the process.
Mm-hmm. That's beautiful. Yeah, thank you for that. I love that. And and I think like it's kind of funny. I think there's almost room for both, right? You can say like, yes, I see you, logical mind.
Yes.
Because sometimes I stop and I say, what even am I doing? Like
yeah.
My analytical mind will come in and say, what even is this? And how uh-huh. is this even doing anything? Because my whole background is in
yes.
software development, project management. And absolutely. So I sometimes have this moment, but then mm-hmm. the expression that always comes back to me is the proof is in the pudding. Mm-hmm. Right. And I've seen so many cases where there's a tangible shift mm-hmm. following a session mm-hmm. that I go with it and I just trust. So mm-hmm. I would just extend that same invitation to one of you that might want to try this out, is like, give space for that skeptic. Like, that's, yes, you know, I get it. And just kind of, if you can have that seed of openness and mm-hmm. recognize there could be something going on here that might not be explainable really that analytically, and it could still work. And
yes, I agree with you. And then you really come from both sides of it. And then you have thought through, right? You know, with the scientific evidence as well. But I think for someone to get the most out of a session, we can leave that little bit of skepticism and analysis to before and after the session, and then just really like focus for the whatever 15 minutes or 30 minutes you have. Just believe and focus. So when I have done the session with you, like, my experience is just my body's tingling. It's like someone giving me a haircut. It's the feeling so warm and so nurturing. Like, just imagine someone else is taking care of you. Like, you know, you have this intention, you know, you want to heal in certain ways. And then there's another being there, and the energy is helping you to go through that together. So I always compare it to me getting a haircut.
Oh, I love
you know, that feeling of like someone's touching your hair, someone's like, you know, feeling it, like trying to make it pretty and do the work, and then you just sit there and you enjoy, you kind of like, you know, experience every second of it.
It's like an emotional spa treatment.
Yes. That's what I'm trying to say. Yes.
Yeah, I love it. Yes. Yeah, perfect.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I think next we're gonna do a sample of the emotion code session with, and Kristy, you're the certified emotion code practitioner, right? That's the title. Yes. So we're gonna do a sample remote session, and then that's gonna be a separate video. I'm gonna put a link around there somewhere in the description, and so feel free to find that and then have a taste of it. Anything else you would like to add before we wrap up?
Oh boy. I mean, yes, I got some great questions there. So nothing specific is coming to mind right now, though I do want to reiterate mm-hmm. that if anyone viewing this has any questions that we didn't cover here, please feel free to reach out. I love talking about the process. I love answering questions, and the whole thing is just so fascinating for me. So please feel free to reach out if you feel called, and I'm happy to answer any questions that might come to you.
Yeah. Okay. And then I'm just going to add one more thing is, because I talk so much about recipes and food, and then it doesn't mean that's really the solution for everything. And it's easier to talk about recipes, talk about nutrition. It's harder to talk about what you do, you know, like in the emotional space. It's there's a lot of vulnerability, and then there's a lot of empathy that you have to put out there and share your stories and be connecting with other people. The work you do is more difficult, more challenging, but that is clearing the blockage. And if people haven't seen results from taking care of their physical body, eating right, doing supplements, and doing all of the stuff that you get at your naturopath's office, maybe look into this emotional piece. And I think that may be just the piece of puzzle.
Put
things together.
That's how Yang and I are so connected, because literally as you were talking there, Yang, I the puzzle analogy came to me, where holistic health truly is, it's like a puzzle, right? And I think you and I both had quite a period of time there where, so if this is our whole puzzle,
we were doing that,
food. If you just hone the food better, cut out one more food, bring in this other food, like we were right in this, we were full on here. And then the whole thing is expanding out and embracing the other pieces that create the beautiful tapestry that is you, right?
So yes. And we both have done that puzzle solving for so many years. And you, like, I'm just going to bring this up just one more time. You have tapped into so many modalities. Like every 3 months, 6 months, you're learning something new, and you know, from all the different diets to different kind of spiritual healing. And then in the end, you landed on emotion code, and I would not have known about it if it's not for you. So thank you, Kristy. And then the fact that you have this vast experience and you're able to, you know, pinpoint something that you find helpful to your friends and your client that really speak just, you know, louder than anything.
Thank you. Thank you. I mean, it's, you know, if you would have asked 17-year-old me if I would be doing this at this point in my life, I would be like, what are you even talking about, right? It's certainly been a journey, but I'm, you know, so grateful that I came into the emotion code, and just, I'm really so grateful for my journey. It certainly has not been easy the whole way. I mean, that's an understatement, but, you know, looking back over the whole thing, I can see the way it kind of everything came to where I am today. And, so just very grateful for you, grateful for Emotion Code, and grateful for being able to do this work and help other people out.
Oh my gosh, I'm grateful for you too, and I love you so much.
I love you too.